Hi, you've just clicked to watch a 30-minute Introduction to Xero for New Users video that I created. Now, the reason why I created this, I've just put a little snippet on the front of this video, is because I realized users, viewers, were not watching the video correctly. To ensure that you view the video in high definition on YouTube, click on the little gear icon in the bar at the bottom of your channel and select 720p or higher high definition. These videos are shot in high definition and you should see them in crystal clear quality. So change that setting so you have the best viewing pleasure of watching this video. Also, please do me a favor. If this video is of use to you, like the video by giving it a thumbs up and share it with your friends and subscribe to my channel. Hello, Heather Smith here. This is an introduction to Xero, an overview for new users who've probably never used Xero before, just to give you a bit of orientation about what's going on with Xero. When you log into Xero, you see a menu bar across the top with probably looks something similar to this. Dashboard, accounts, payroll, reports, advisor, contact, settings. Now, depending on what user status you have and depending on what country you've set up your Xero file in, depends on whether you'll have access to payroll and whether you'll have access to the advisor options. Now, if you when you open up, you go straight to the dashboard. But what the dashboard has on it is a small mini summary of the bank accounts, the sales dashboard, the purchases dashboard, and your expense claims area. So you can see if you click on the accounts tab, the drop-down option on the accounts, you actually get to access these areas. You also get to access fixed assets, giving you a sort of an inbuilt fixed asset register within Xero. Now, for the Australian users, you get to access payroll here, and you get an overview. You get click on employees to get the details behind the employees. You can see the employee pay runs. If you use them, you can access timesheets, and if necessary, access superannuation. The next option along is reports. Here, you can access all reports and the budget manager. If there are particular reports that you favorite, that you use on a regular basis, you can put a star beside them when you click down through this area, and they too can appear on this drop-down menu. The next one along you can see has lots of different options there, but this is only for someone with financial advisor user access within Xero. So many people may not even get access to this area. But you can enter manual journals here, you can see management reporting information here, you can see for the Australian users activity statements, the BAS and the income activity statements can be accessed here. Plus you have your end of financial year reporting, your reconciliation reports, and you have the option to export information from Xero here. The next one along is contacts, which pretty much everyone can access depending on their user access to contacts. But here you have customers and supplier contacts. In fact, within Xero, all contacts are set up the same way, but you can just group them in the particular areas if you need to. You can also set up contact groups. So maybe you want to simply contact customers who live outside your country. You can group them into a specific group, and they would also be seen here on this drop-down options. The next one along is settings. These are your general settings for setting up the structure of your Xero data file. So if you're a manager, management accountant, or a business owner, the primary areas that you would initially focus on are the dashboard and the reports area, and you may access some of the other areas. But as a business owner, a manager, management accountant, those are the areas I would be initially focusing on. If you're the tax accountant, I would be focusing on the advisor area, which may lead you to look at the other areas, but that would be my primary focus. If you're the BAS agent or the bookkeeper working in Xero, the areas that you'll be looking at are the accounts areas, payroll areas, the advisor area, contacts, and settings area. Now, the BAS agent bookkeeper may or may not have access to the advisor area. It depends on the level of the work that you're doing with the business and whether they want you accessing that sort of area. So there you have it, a very brief introduction to Xero to hopefully give you some guidance in what areas you should be looking at initially when you actually go and start using Xero. Thank you. Hello. Today I'm doing an introduction to Xero's dashboard, an overview for the new user. This is what the Xero dashboard looks like, the home dashboard, once it's got some information in there. So the one that you're looking at for your own personal business may not look as busy as this one does. We have on the dashboard a quick overview or mini dashboards of our bank accounts, our credit card accounts, our payment gateways such as PayPal, and on the right-hand side, our account watch list, money coming in, money going out, and our expense claims. So let's have a look at this in more detail. On the left-hand side, we have our bank accounts that are set up as bank accounts, as credit card accounts, as payment gateways that can have bank feeds activated and feeding into them, or bank feeds importing into them. So you can see here that we have the name of the bank account up the top here. We have here the balance, the current balance in Xero, and the current statement balance feeding in from the bank statement. And here, the blue button here is where we click through to go and reconcile information, the underlying information of this bank account. The graph shows us the current balance. You can see there it's 215,158, hasn't changed in a while for those periods. And up here we can go in and we have the option to manage the account, do further things with this account, or we can click through and go into banking and deal with other banking issues that we may have. So you can see I have just my general bank accounts linked up there. I can also link up my Visa and my MasterCard credit card accounts. And again, same thing again, I can manage the accounts. You can see this one, the bank feed hasn't actually been activated for it. So I'm in a position that I would want to be importing my bank statements or go through the process of activating the feed. And down here I have my online payment gateway. This is my PayPal account. And if you have a business PayPal account, the feed can feed, the transactional feed can feed into Xero. Now, if you are accepting money via PayPal but haven't yet upgraded to a business PayPal account, from my understanding, the fees are the same as a personal account as they are for a business account. So you'll need to check that to see if that's still currently the situation. And it's my understanding that Xero will be adding additional payment gateways, which can then be added here as active bank feeds, which will be exciting and again minimize your data entry. Let's move over to the right hand side. At the very top here we have a mini dashboard, an accounts watch list. So these are general ledger accounts that we can nominate to watch here on the list. So I suggest you are actively monitoring between 3 and 10 accounts, and you may put up here things such as income accounts, liability accounts, those that you actually are going to owe money on. You may put up here a particular liability account where you're paying down a car loan, so you're monitoring how much you actually owe on that. And you can see you have the information here of the current month and the year-to-date balances. And from here, you can click through, drill down, and go to the chart of the accounts. So the dashboard is a great place to come to get a quick overview of what's going on in your business. Then you can drill down and see further information about it. Going down a bit further, we have the money coming in. and money coming in, we have a bar chart here. So for those who like bar charts, you can hover over it and see, well, these look like overdue amounts that were due last month and 2 months ago and currently due and some future income coming in. We can see draft invoices, so we may want to drill down on that and activate them. We can see some overdue invoices, and we again may want to drill down on that and chase outstanding debts. We, from this point, can add sales invoices, and we can click over here on the Go to Sales to drill down into the actual sales dashboard. Just underneath the sales dashboard is the purchases or the money going out dashboard, which is a mirror image of what we just saw in sales. We have bar chart here highlighting what is awaiting payment. We have a little stretchy bar underneath highlighting. So this will only be useful if you're actually entering information about what is due for payment. You have here click through to draft bills, click through to overdue bills, and I'll remind you that if you are using these options to make sure that the information in them is correct. If you've put a bill in and then decide not to pay it, you need to go in and amend that. From here we can click on and add additional bills, and from here we can drill down into our purchases area. So going down a bit further, we have an expense claims area. Some businesses may never actually ever use this area, the expense claims, but if you're the type of business that has maybe people go out onto site and they do a job and they submit a claim for approval, that can be processed through the expense claim. Here you can add your receipts, you can view your current claims, and you can submit the claim for authorization. So this means it's waiting authorization, and this highlights all current claims, and this highlights claims that are awaiting payment. So you would probably be submitting them maybe to your manager for authorization, and then you await payment maybe from the finance department. That's happening in a big office. In a small micro business, you may do all of that yourself. And even if you are a micro business, you may use this area because when you have your iPhone, you can scan a receipt, upload it, and when you do upload it, it actually occurs. It actually is submitted here. So you would see it here, and then you would go through the process. So it's a nice, tidy area to identify expense claims or payments that have not gone through your bank accounts, okay? Really want people to process payments through their bank accounts, but if they don't, if they do it by cash, this is an option, okay? Now, just down the bottom here, this is a fun little area, and overall, you can tell people how you're feeling about Xero. So hopefully, you're always feeling, yay, very happy about using your Xero system. Hello, Heather Smith here. In today's session, we are giving an introduction to Xero's accounts. This is really an overview for the new user. So, under your accounts menu drop-down option, you have five different options: bank accounts, sales, purchases, expense claims, and fixed assets. So the first one, which is where we've started at, is our bank account area. Here you can see all the bank accounts that have been set up in Xero. Now, the terminology in Xero for bank accounts actually refers to bank accounts, credit cards, or PayPal. So remember, when I talk about bank, I mean bank accounts, credit cards, or PayPal. So this was on the dashboard, the home dashboard, and is actually in more detail here. So you can see the individual accounts. I've got my bank, my high interest, my credit card, and my PayPal. And you can see I actually have this stretchy bar underneath, so giving me, scoping me so I can see more information, more detail of what's going on here. And what else can I do here? Here I can add new bank accounts, so I can add a bank account, credit card, or PayPal account. I can transfer money. I can access my bank rules. As with the dashboard, I could manage my accounts here, and I can also reconcile my accounts here. This option down here gives me the option to show the account on the dashboard. So if I had an account that perhaps was quite stagnant, not moving at all, I may untick this option so it doesn't appear there. Now if I just scroll down a little bit, I have here the option to update the order on the main dashboard. So if I slip them around, you can see here that my high interest and my savings accounts have swapped around, and this, if I then click on my dashboard, I should be able to see has happened on my dashboard. The high interest is at the top and the savings account is at the bottom. So I'll pop back in here. Now you should always think about your dashboard, and you really want to have the most important one at the top. So I'm going to move the savings account back there. So think about that. It's important to have your dashboard with the most important relevant information with you so you can make decisions, and that's one of the options there to change that. So that's looking at our accounts. The next area I want to quickly look at is my sales area. So if I click on my sales, this is my sales dashboard, and I have various options here. At the top, I can create new invoices, repeating invoices, and credit notes. I can send statements. I can import sales information. I can search for invoices within my database. And I have some sort of quick tabs and quick areas to jump down and drill down on here. So my invoices that have been paid, my repeating invoices, all of my invoices, draft, awaiting approval, awaiting payment, and the overdue ones, I can quickly jump down and see the further information. So if I came to my sales dashboard, my primary reason may be to create new invoices or to chase up overdue invoices. If I come down a little bit further, I have this nice little dashboard here of money coming in, and you can see as I hover across it, it shows me the information, phone number, mobile phone number, what's due, and so I can easily contact those people if I need to chase up with that payment. And on the right hand side here, it says I've got another little mini information table. Customers owing the most money. So currently highlighting the customers who owe me the most money, and it is in a listed format here. The red is highlighting which is overdue, and if I click on the pie, it actually shows me a pie chart, just whatever you prefer, and you can see the pie chart really clearly identifies who owes you the most money. And it's really encouraging you to be proactive with your cash flow, because you're constantly going, okay, the chunk of pie here is big, the bar box here is big, this is the one I need to get the money from. I guess when it's in this list format, it's not so obvious which one is maybe the biggest one. It is maybe for a numerical person, but this is good graphical. Okay, this is where we should be chasing the money from. And obviously for this business, it's these three big chunks here that we should be chasing the money actively for. So that is our accounts and a quick overview of our sales dashboard. If I click down further, I come to my purchases dashboard. My purchases is very much the same as my sales. It very much orientates itself as a mirror image of my sales. So I'm going to look at my purchases. I have my new, I have importing purchases, the option to search. Again, same sort of options here. What's overdue? What's awaiting payment? What's draft? The opportunity to see them all. And I have here a big bar chart with the see all upcoming bills with a stretchy bar underneath, so I can sort of see what upcoming bills they are. And then here I have highlighted the blue have been due and the green are what has actually been paid. So this area will only have information in it as if you are actively entering supplier invoices. If you're not actively entering supplier invoices, then this area might be quite bare. Popping up here, we'll then go and have a look at our expense claims area. Just giving you a brief overview of the expense claims area, you have here the option to add your receipts, view what current claims are and actually see the detail of them, view what previous claims are, what's awaiting authorization, awaiting payment and what has been archived, perhaps has been filed away. You also have at the bottom here history and notes and the option to add additional notes here. Finally, in the accounts area, we want to look at the fixed assets. Some people will never ever go and have a look at the fixed assets, so we just want to have a look here. Some people will never touch this area. It may just be left for the tax accountant. So from here, this fixed asset area here, we can add new assets, we can depreciate an asset, we can import assets if necessary, and we, under the tabs, can see what's pending, what's registered, what's sold and disposed. And you have the option here to delete them and search for them. So that gives you a quick overview of what is available in the Xero Accounts tab area. Hello, Heather Smith here. In this session, I'm going to introduce you to Xero's payroll. This is an overview for beginners, for those who are really new to Xero. So when you go into Xero and click on payroll, you have five drop-down options: overview, employees, pay runs, timesheets, and superannuation. Now, you only have access to this if you're using the Australian version of Xero. So if you're not using the Australian version, you don't need to watch this. This is not going to give you any probably useful information for what you're doing. So if we click on overview, we end up here. And here at our overview page, we can see a draft pay run. You can only have one pay run running at any particular time, one draft pay run running at any particular time. You can see a block of previous pay runs with the option to view all pay runs. You can see pending leave applications. So these are leave applications that people have applied for, and they haven't actually been processed. The date hasn't come around, so they haven't been fully processed yet. But they're pending leave applications. And here we have upcoming leave. So this upcoming leave has been fully approved, and again, the date hasn't come around yet. Okay, so let's pop up and we'll go and have a look at, I should also highlight any of the lines that I hover across. I could click on and drill down further into. And if I say click here on last name, it will sort it for me. So it just gives you some other information there. If I go in, I can actually sort it, and that might be useful to you. Clicking on the payroll, I'm now going to click on employees. And this shows me, this is where I go and find all of the employee details. So the underlying details is in under all of these lines. From here, I can add employees, I can view payment summaries, I can come up here and sort them so I can see who's active and who's terminated. I can group them by employee groups and view them by particular employee groups. I also have the option here, if I opted here, I could invite a particular employee to view their employee portal, which is can be quite useful for them. So underlying here, I see all the employee details. I want to highlight to you that you could set an employee up in contacts, but that is not linking them to be processed in the Australian Xero payroll. So I primarily see them here, see the detail here if I want to process them through Xero payroll. Let's look at the next option. Click here, third one down, pay runs. Pay runs. So here in pay runs, I'm just going to close that down. I have here my draft pay run and my pay run history. So you can see that this information was in the payroll overview area as well. And if I want to extend the real estate, I could drop down and show 50 lines here per items per page. Doesn't look like I have that many, but if I needed to, I could do that. Popping back up here and click here in on the fourth option down, which is timesheets. So some businesses may not use timesheets at all, but if you do use timesheets, you can see them all listed here. You have a filtering option up the top here that gives you the option to filter them by draft, pending approval, awaiting approval, approved, processed, or overdue, start and end dates, employment groups, employees, and allows you to view those particular timesheets. You also have the option to add timesheets here and the option to approve timesheets if you're in a position to actually approve them, if you have a user status to approve them. So you may either spend time here or you perhaps don't, will never use this area at all. It's one of those sorts of areas. And finally, if I click up here, I have the option for superannuation. Now, this is for automatic superannuation payments. This is for businesses who are on the high end of Xero, who are using the larger Xero package, the Australian Xero package, and they can set up automatic superannuation payments, which will minimize the actual data entry and administrative involved with processing payroll in Xero. Hello, Heather Smith here. In this session, we are doing an introduction to Xero reports. This is a beginner session, an overview for the very new user. So when you click on the reports tab on the menu bar, you have two options available to you, All Reports and Budget Manager. So if you click on All Reports, this is the screen that you actually come to. Now there's a few things to be aware of here. We have a few reports here, performance, cash reports, foreign currency reports, which would only be available to those who are on the large end scale package and can do multiple currency in Xero. Payroll reports, a few payroll reports there. Those would only be available to Australian users who have payroll. There are a few payroll reports for other users. Position reports and detail reports. Now, a few things to highlight. If I actually come over here and click on something that's popular, profit and loss statement and balance sheet. So I've highlighted those two ones. I've put a little blue star beside them. If I now click on reports, you can see that they are now listed as my favorites. So I can add additional reports to my favorites. The other thing to note is there are four tabs back here: summary, draft, publish, and archived. So I can look at reports, customize reports, and save them as draft. I can formally publish them, and I can archive them. Now, the other area to look at here is the budget manager. So let's just click on that and see what I can do here. So the budget manager, it looks like I have a budget set up here. From here, I can select budgets or I can add new budgets. It's really good to know that you can actually add multiple different budgets. So you can have a main budget and then reforecast it perhaps every quarter, depending, updating it with information that you know that's coming through from the economic environment and from your business internally. I've got start dates and the actuals. So if I actually want the actual real information for that period, next to the budgeted information, and then allowing me how many periods I want, 3, 6, 12, 24. And I can click on update there to give myself the information there. Then I have the overall budget information here. This is kind of, if I click on wide view, this gives you opportunity actually to see wide view. And I can enter in my budgeted information here, and as I scroll down, I have four options at the bottom. I can import information, I can export it, I can save it, and I can cancel it. Okay, so I'm just going to cancel that and back down to standard view. So I clicked wide view, standard view. Hello, Heather Smith here. This is a beginner session for understand the advisor tab in Xero. If you look at your menu bar, you may have this option here, advisor. However, not everyone does. Only those with user access to the advisor area will have this option. But whether you do or don't have this option, you might be interested to know what is going on here. So you can see that there are six drop-down options from here. And manual journals, management reports, activity statements, annual accounts, reconciliation reports, and exports. So let's just take a quick look and have a look at them. manual journals. This is the first tab that we're looking at here, and this is where you can go through and enter a manual journal. However, the way Xero works is that you shouldn't really need to do too many manual journals. You should hopefully be able to avoid too many manual journals. And you can add a new journal here, and you can import journals here, and you can save them as draft, and you can post them. Next tab down is management report. This is quite an interesting area. From here, you can look at various ratios, key performing indicators of your business, and you have them all summarized, all the key reports summarized in one area. So you can look at them here, you can comment on them here, and you can publish a report which you can sort of save and review, reflect back on. Next option is our activity statement. This is where you, did that click? Yes, it's coming through. This is where you can come in and look at a business activity statement or an installment activity statement. Set it up for the particular period. You can see that looks there. Set it up for the particular period, review the GST on it, and produce relevant BAS or income activity statements as you require. The next option down is annual accounts, SPFR, which is special purpose financial reporting. And so here you have the option to publish the reports at, depending on the entity type, be it company, sole trader, partnership or trust. So maybe something that's relevant to you, or you may simply leave this to the tax accountant. But you can see you've got all the information in there that will sort of all be summarized in one point, one place in within Xero. On the fifth tab, we have reconciliation. So you can see here under reconciliation, we've got various different options to choose from. This is defaulted there. Let's change the date there and we'll update it. But you've got your trial balance happening there. You can also go in and see your age receivables, age payables, and you can go and see your check account and see whether it's reconciled. And what you really want to see is that these two amounts have reconciled. And if they haven't, what that's suggesting is the balance in Xero is different to the actual statement balance, and you need to investigate further what's gone on there. The next option down is export. And from here, you can export the data from Xero into a number of different products. And these seem to be updating all the time. So if you need to export the information, you can export it into a number of different products here. This is a brief introduction to contacts in Xero. If you click on the contacts option on the menu bar, you'll see all contacts, customers and suppliers. Customers and suppliers can be both customers and suppliers. And if you have imported contacts, as has happened in this file, you may have lots of contacts listed here. And then as they are applied to a sales invoice, they'll fall into the customer's filter. And as they are applied to a supplier's bill, they'll fall into the supplier's filter. And they may be listed under both of them. You'll also see here that we have archive contacts who are no longer used but have some information there perhaps on them. Up the top here we have some options: add contact, add new group, import and export. And down here we have the options add to group, merge and archive. Now I want to show you the new group option here. So if I just click on these three, I'll click on those four there, and I'm going to click add to group, and I'm going to call the group contacts contractors, and I'm clicking save. Up here, if we click on contacts in the drop down arrow option, you'll see we now have contractors added there as an additional group. And if we click on that, we come straight through to this dashboard of the contractors, which may be useful if you deal with that grouping of associates in a different way or do different things with them. But if you wanted to get rid of it, very simple, click on that, delete group. All very editable and flexible. The other option we have here is merge. So if we wanted to, we have AH Jackson here and we can merge him with AIPP. And if they had been created by mistake, we can merge them and they're gone. You'll notice the archived has popped up to 8 now. The information has been merged. The history has gone through onto that one single contact, and the other information has been archived. And you've been received a notification of what has happened up here. AH Jackson has been merged, and you can view the information, or you can close that down. So there you have it. Brief. Hello, this is a beginner's overview of settings in Xero. If you click on Settings in Xero, you have to click on General Settings to get through to this section. And you can see it's split out into three areas: Organization, Features, and Connect. So the organization is pretty much how the data file in Xero has been set up. You have your organization settings here, financial settings here. You have conversion balances, which once they've been set up perhaps by your accountant, you'll not touch again. Again, you'll have tax rates here, which again, hopefully you don't need to, once they're set up, change. Here we have tracking, which is very similar to sort of a jobs tracking system, and you may come in here and add additional tracking options. And across here you have users. If you need to invite additional users to Xero, this is where you would go. Now, dropping down here, we have our features, and this is where we can have a little customization of various areas. So we can customize invoice settings, we can add inventory items, we can add currencies. If we have a large file, we can add currencies. And if we need to manage our payroll settings, this is where we jump in, manage our payroll settings. We also have the option to customize and manage our email settings here. Now over on the right hand side, we have the connect area. So this is where we connect other Xero files to our own Xero file, and this is where we can add add-on solutions. So I want to show you something. I'm going to just untick that. If I click on settings, you'll see it just simply says general settings there. But what will be beneficial is if you click on the chart of accounts, and if you track over here and click on tracking, because this might be one that you use on a frequent basis. If there's other things there, such as inventory items that you use on a frequent basis, click on them, favorite them, and you'll see if I click on this drop-down option, I have them there, easily accessible. Thank you for watching the video. This is how you can get in touch with me if you need further assistance in using your Xero solution, if you need setup, support, or training. And please like this video by giving it a thumbs up, sharing it with your friends, and subscribe to my video channel. Please visit me at my website. Thank you.